Puddle of Mud then with Blurry. It is Kerrang Radio. You, me at six. Hello!
Hello!
How are you doing?
Yeah, good, thanks.
Got Josh and Max in the studio. You enjoyed listening to that, weren't you?
Definitely did enjoy listening to a bit Puddle of Mud. About how good they were.
Don't you posting the video up on Facebook, you said the other day?
Yeah, my mate Alex posted a video up of Blurry, and I was like, I forgot how much a tune it was, so I had to go back and listen to the back catalogue.
Yes, totally, the back. What were you doing when that was coming out then? Do you remember?
I was actually sitting down watching Kerrang TV when I heard that for the first time.
Really?
I was indeed.
Kerrang's been good to you, boys.
Kerrang's been
it?
A bit amazing, right, to me. All my life.
All my life.
All my life.
So how is life then with you guys? It's kind of Promageddon at the moment, isn't it?
Yeah.
Album just come out.
It's very
dropped.
Good. We found out this morning we're number one at the moment. The album's
yes,
one.
Yes,
so.
Get in.
Well, rock band
yes.
at number one.
And
get
I thought
in.
Rock and roll was dead, according to The Guardian. So they can, you know. And just feeling really, really good about that at the moment. And just super, super busy with all the kind of promo and installs we're doing. And,
yeah,
and
yeah.
then tour kicks off on Saturday night in Preston, so...
Nice to be back on the road.
Yeah, it's been about 7-8 months since we've actually done a proper tour, so I think we're all excited to get out and play some new songs and just actually play to all our fans again, you know?
Yeah, definitely. What happens when you get a number one from your label? Do you get presents? What happens?
I don't know. I'm actually going to send... I was just sending Max, like, Coldplay a tour in December, so I'm just going to send our MD an email today, being like, so...
Only chance we go see Coldplay.
Let's sort some tickets out, shall we? The mother wants to go, so just might try and be cheeky now.
You got things like that,
I don't know. To be honest, like, our label have been really good to us, like, backing us for the last, 2 and 3 years, so if anything, they probably deserve this as much as we do, so... All very exciting.
Oh,
times.
That's very nice. He's been brought up well, hasn't he? He's a proper Surrey boy.
He's a good
isn't
lad.
He?
Okay, well polite, well mannered.
Do you, what do you think about sort of when people say, oh, the band from Surrey? That's when you just went, oh, here we go.
Is
it like a little pet gripe of yours? Because my mum was from Surrey and my dad was from the East End. That didn't last.
Oh, it's one of those things where, like, when I say, oh, I live in Weybridge, like, oh, cool. So your little mummy and daddy's boy and they've paid for everything your band's done. It's like, yeah, I live in the near the council houses. I don't live in a council house, but the St. George's Hill, which is like Cliff Richard and Kerry Katona will live there. And then, like, I live a road opposite, which is like... 3-bedroom normal house. It's
I don't
want
to live near Kerry Katona.
No, nor do I.
I don't think anybody wants to live near Kerry Katona.
But it's got a reputation of being quite an affluent area, and I guess, like, in a way it is, but at the same time, like, it's never had anything to do with me and our music and what we've done, so...
We just got the good manners from Surrey, that's all
we
have.
That's all we got.
Yeah, well,
we've got these stupid accents and that's about it.
So, Sinners Never Sleep is the name of the record.
Yeah.
You had this, like, big 5-day countdown, didn't you, on the website when you were saying there's new material coming and blah, blah, blah. It's a weird world where you have to think a bit more outside the box of just turning up and playing now, isn't it? You've got to think of all these marketing campaigns. Have you had a really, really bad one that you've all sat down and gone, no, we can't do that?
No, the thing is actually this is the first time we've actually felt that we actually did it right.
Right, okay. We
usually feel like we try and, like, do something, like on the last record, we tried to do stuff that we weren't comfortable with, kind of, because we just signed a major label and all that kind of stuff. And this time around, we're just kind of, it was a conscious decision to just be us and take us for face value. And it's actually the way it should work, you know, like an honest approach is usually the way it works. So
we just had an idea as well, what we wanted to do with this.
We had
a lot more ideas and we were a lot more prepared for it this time. So that definitely really helped us out in the process.
That's all good.
Cool.
Wonderful. Yeah, people can see through the lies, can't they? So fair play on that. What are you going to do today? Because this is weird doing like a really stripped back acoustic kind of thing, isn't it? Do you find it quite
nerve-wracking? I love it. I think it's wicked, because I don't have to sing full voice. I can just basically talk into a microphone.
Like you were over Puddle of Mud.
Yeah, exactly.
I can take it.
I like it because I think it's kind of cool and I like when we play acoustic as well. So
it's because a different vibe as well.
Yeah. So we're going to play a few songs from Hold Me Down, a few songs from Sins Never Sleep, and that'll be that.
Wonderful. Well, it's nice to meet you.
This is our first time, isn't it?
Thank you very much.
It is our first.
I'll never forget it now.
Oh, nor me. Right, let's play Jaws on the Floor, which is the first music release from this record, wasn't it? Sort of online, wasn't it?
I think
Loverboy was.
It was going so well.
I was going to say such good things about you now when I leave.
I thought this was the first teaser kind of thing.
It was.
I played this. I had
Kerrang Radio had the exclusive.
Yeah, very exclusive.
I did it. I remember
there
it.
There you go.
Privilege. Love you again.
Thank you. Jaws on the Floor, you be at six. Thank you, boys.